Australia began the second session of day four, still at the start of a daunting run chase. Having put on 28 without loss before lunch, they still needed another 283 runs for victory in this first Investec Ashes test. Shane Watson resuming unbeaten on 18 and Chris Rogers on 10. And the openers continued to make some swift progress as their partnership soon passed 50. Rogers nicking this one off Jimmy Anderson, but it didn't carry to second slip and brought up the half-century stand as England's frustration began to build. Watson too was striking the ball well. This was his eighth four as he sent Broad backward a point to the boundary and appeared to be heading towards his own 50 with Australia looking comfortable. But that all changed with the first ball after the drinks break as Broad responded in style. His in-swinger had Watson trapped for 46, and although the decision was reviewed and proved a close call, the umpire's decision stood and England had a vital breakthrough. They thought they'd got Rogers as well in the very next over when he was also given out, caught behind off Graham Swan, only for the Australians to review this one as well. And this time they were right to do so. Replay showing there was no edge, nor was LBW an issue, so Rogers survived the scare. Ed Cowan had now joined him in the middle, and despite a nervous start, maybe influenced by his first ball duck in the first innings, it was he who took the tourist total into three figures this time, with a second boundary in the space of three balls from Swan. After his reprieve, Rogers went on to reach a maiden test half-century, fully justifying his call-up at the age of 35 with an innings of authority. But another twist with what proved the last ball before tea was taken as Joe Root claimed his first test wicket, having just been brought into the attack. Cowan went for the big drive through cover, but picked out only Jonathan Trott at first slip and was gone for 14. England striking a big blow with that second wicket, which leaves the equation fairly straightforward, with four sessions still left in the match. Australia on 111 for two, having added 83 after lunch, need another 200 runs for victory. England require eight more wickets.